between you and me. When I hear your voice, I know I'm finally free. Every single word is perfect as it can be. And I need you here with me. When you lift me up, I know that I'll never fall. I can speak to you by saying nothing at all. Every single time I find it harder to breathe. Cause I need you here with me. Every day you're saying the words that I want you to say. There's a pain in my heart and it won't go away. Now I know I'm falling in deep.
Me, ma'am. Can you send security personnel upstairs to the east side? There's a Cocker Spaniel, pet dog here that's trying to get to him. And this is not a pet-friendly mall. Upstairs on the east side.
On the east side, over towards the garage?
Yes. It just got on the elevator to go upstairs.
So it's leaving?
No. Like, they're inside the mall, going and shopping. Get in my bag and grab my wallet. The big pocket. It's in my red wallet.
Here.
He's fine. He can handle it well. It's just, what if it's not? It's a small dog, I get that, but it's also illegal to pass your pet off. And she's like, well, what if it is a service dog? It's not. Hold that. You know you have every legal right to kick them out when they come in. You have two questions you can ask them. Is it a service dog? What tasks does it perform? And if they say emotional support or nothing at all, or if it's even acting up or acting not as a service dog.
If it's counter surfing at Cinnabon, it's not.
No, you guys have every legal right to kick them out. Yeah, of course. And I'm going to give you guys some ADA cards. I actually work in this building. I work upstairs at Hot Topic. And he was recently attacked here maybe 6 or 7 months ago. And he got to my bed. Good boy. And it's just, I understand that it's a small dog and it didn't.
Yeah, Lord, what is it? You know what
I know. Yeah. But even a small dog can make my dog wash if it were to attack him. This is one of the ADA cards. I can get you another one here.
So I'm going to attach it to this, and I'm giving it to my manager because I'm tired of the wishy-washy.
I was going to say,
she stays at home. She doesn't need to show.
Well, and then people say, oh, well, it's my emotional support dog. I understand that, but emotional support dogs live and fly with you, and they don't have public access. They aren't allowed out in public. Where are
and
my
I'm
other
tired
dogs?
Of that excuse.
Oh, here they are.
My dog is so awful on a leash.
I'm just happy that I saw it. It was like right when I came out of the elevator and I had a hold of him and like stopped at the door and I told her, I was like, can you please like back up? I have a service dog. And at that point I said, you do realize that this is a service dog only place. And she's like, well, how do you know it's not a service dog? I said,
because
it's trying to get to my dog. It's actively trying to get to my dog. It's obviously very much a pet. Here, I'll give you one of the fancy ones too to keep up here just in case. If you see anything, this is what you need to call. The ADA hotline is on here also, and the website that you can talk to them if you have any questions or anything like that. And I understand that people are very scared to get sued. I understand that, but all they're going to do is go in front of a judge, and they're going to see that that's not what it is. What date is it?
It is the 4th, August 4th.
Because I also have, like I said, I had an experience here where he did about get fully attacked. Luckily, there was a man there. It was an off-duty Marine, ironically, and basically like chokeslammed this woman's Burmese Mountain Dog because it came that close to biting in the face.
It's huge.
Yeah, it was very scary, and it was very bad.
very frustrating. The law of human force. So I have attaching me to
their complaints. That, and most of the security here knows me. Like I said, I work here. So anytime I see anything like that, I do go and like tell them. But there's a lot of times where they get lost in people. Or me confronting them about it and freaks them out, and I tell them, yo, that's illegal. You can serve jail time and fines for that. And then they get freaked out and leave, which by all means do so. But, you know.
I just don't know why Rover needs to go shopping.
That's, I don't understand. I don't have a choice to take him.
I know.
What I'm saying is I don't have a choice. I don't have a choice. And, like, if I was able to go without him, I would. It's annoying. He's trained to do what he's supposed to do, but it's annoying. I can't imagine taking a dog that has no idea what it's doing out.
Oh, I've done it.
Look out for dogs. I said it is busy today. Look out for dogs. And no sooner than we leave, there's one. I just went to the Ohio State Fair, and there were six people passing their dogs off. Six. I think you have a customer. One dog to attack him and to mess it all up. And then I'm $20,000 down the drain. And then me, as a disabled person, what am I supposed to do? He's the reason I'm allowed to work. I'm allowed to drive. I'm allowed to go to my doctor's appointments without assistance, go out without assistance. This is my independence. My chair and him are my independence. What else am I supposed to do? And I don't think people see it as, oh, well, it's just a dog. It's just a dog. It's not just a dog. You're endangering people who rely on their dogs, and you're endangering other people who don't know anything. You damage my reputation as a service dog family. That's why I get denied access. That's why I have to deal with shit all day, every day.
You get denied access.
Oh, yeah. I have people tell me, there's no dogs here. No dogs. And they don't understand that just because Rover, the one that they brought in, bit your waitress, doesn't mean that my dog is going to do that. Most of the time, people don't even know he's there because he's tucked up underneath the boot, and people don't even know he's there. He's an 80-pound German Shepherd, and no one knows he's there. That is our goal as handlers, is to make them.
Watch them train up here.
Yeah. There's Ohio State, who does service dogs. There's Buckeye, who does service dogs. Canines, Canine Companions. Yeah. The Ohio State girls are the ones who do the canine companions. So they work together to do it. We have a service dog group that comes up here all the time. This is where we like to train because of how many people are here.
Yeah, I know. I love it. I love watching them. And then they train with the people getting the dogs.
Oh, yeah.
And they're always welcome.
I wrote, this is This is going to be the whole group of service dog handlers that live here in Columbus and live in Ohio. This is who are all in there. So we have people who come up here all the time. So if they wanted any of that information or anybody else, there's that too.
Like I said, Kane is one of our partners.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't understand. If you have a service dog company as your partner, what the fuck?
I'm going to make this. I fuss all the time about it because it just really hurts my butt.
There's that.
I'm going to fuss even more now.
Yeah, and also I suggest the security is the one who usually handles it. So those you can make copies of. You can even print them out online and make copies of them and make them understand that those are the two questions they are legally allowed to ask and what a service dog behaves like. You know, accidents happen. He does one bark alert, so he sometimes does bark. It's an alert. But there's a difference between bark, 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 and him doing woof, and then that's it. So it is a very blurred line. But you can tell. Yeah, I don't understand how people can tell. That, don't quote me on it, but 99% of people with flexi leashes on their dogs, those are not service dogs. Flexi leashes are of the devil, and it's why he got hit in the face.
They really are.
They're of the devil.
I bought my devil dog with two leashes, not longer than 6 feet.
Yeah.
And I have both hands on because she was a rescue.
I was going to say, it's called responsibility. If you know your dog is like that, don't take him in public. That, and I have no shame for anybody who muzzles their dog. Your dog doesn't deserve to stay inside if it has issues, but you need to be responsible enough to know that it has issues and muzzle your dog.
She doesn't attack anybody, but she bounces.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, I just keep her away from other dogs unless she knows.
Oh, yeah.
We just crossed the
street. I was going to take it.
Oh, can you shove it in there? Cool. Thanks, man. So I didn't get a video of the dog. It was a little Cocker Spaniel. I was too busy telling her what she was doing was illegal and then Jackson wheeling me away from the dog.
And yelling at the bitch.
And yelling at her. Well, not yelling at her, but telling her she's...
I told her to stop.
Yeah. She's a bad person. And then I went to the management, which is the front desk, and she was absolutely lovely and also agrees that there is a huge problem. And as I was writing that review, ironically, a wiener dog walked by on a flexi leash. Yep. Walked by on a flexi leash. So I know for a fact that there are two here that are actively going inside the malls and inside the stores. So we're just kind of trying to keep an eye out. I just want to go to Sephora and look at some stuff. And then we're probably going to leave because I really don't want to risk Denali getting nailed today. So... yeah, I'm gonna go look at makeup and then figure out what we're gonna do next. So yeah. Sorry.
Meet again.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm just trying to get to the other side. You guys are okay. Do you guys know anything about service dogs?
Yes, we know that you're not supposed to interact with them.
Mm-hmm.
And
mean, that's all.
They're trained to help specific disabled people, okay? And you did the right thing. You guys didn't acknowledge him. You completely acted like nothing was there. So, if you guys want, you can give him a treat. So you get to interact with him as a treat because you guys did the right thing, okay? Give me 1 second here. I'll give you guys a goodie to get him, okay? There's 2 treats for you.
I don't really like when dogs lick me, so can I put it on the ground?
Yeah, you can put it on the ground. Wherever they're welcome. There you guys go.
Thank you.
Yeah, you guys have a good day. Step back. Oh, can you get it? There we go. I was going to say, if you guys ask, they should have actual makeup wipes so you can get all of it off. Because, trust me, I swatch lipsticks here all the time and it's real hard to get them off.
Yeah.
Well, you guys have a good day, okay?
You too.
Okay, that's enough. Good boy.
More than one way to wash your hands after Sephora.
Well, throw this on your face.
Liz, no. Ah, why are you like this? Hold on. I'm actually gonna give Denali a try. Is he here?
No. He wanted to do something this week and he was like, what do you want to do? I was like, I don't know. He said, do you want to go clubbing at a gay bar or something? And this thing was like, hell yeah, brother.
I like how you, that is your scene. Literally a club sounds like my worst nightmare.
I've only been to like 2, so I don't really know for sure.
We just got an anthropology. We were looking around. So now we're gonna go back to the car because the mall actually is closed. It's a Sunday. So yeah, we are gonna go back to the car and I don't know if we're gonna go probably to Michael's or Joanne's for just a little bit and then
oh, we
can
go
home
because they close at 7.
Wee! Come on. Good boy, Denali. A good boy. Handsome. Woof. Yep, it was right there where the dog was when he got attacked that one time. Hi, buddy. Come on. It's taken me forever to get him to walk by that and not freak out. Hey, leave it. Let's go now. Good boy. We are back in the car in the AC. I took my hair down. We took some really cute pictures at one of the other displays for the 20 years of Easton. And now we're gonna go to either Joanne's or Michael's, probably Michael's first. And then I'm going to go home and organize my house because I just moved and it needs organized. So I will see you guys at Michael's. All right, so we are at Hellmart. We went to Michael's and I didn't find really what I was looking for, but you know, whatever. So we're at Walmart to do some grocery shopping because I need some food for my house.
I'm cooking chicken parmesan.
So yeah, I'm gonna go to Hellmart and hope for the best.
Good boy. Let's go.
Are you weeding? You aren't even eating the grass. He's just ripping it out. You're such a ding dong. Okay, that's enough. That's enough. No more. Get over here. Lay down. No, lay down. There.